seat belt, ready to go. What's up, everybody, and welcome. It's bright and early here. We are headed to a 28 Vantage Boston Whaler, brand new one, 2023. It's about a 45-minute drive, so I'm going to get there, and we have a joystick problem. It's a brand new boat, so maybe we'll learn some today, or hopefully we'll figure out what's wrong with it. So I'll see you there. Now, we made it here, and we're way out on the docks. It's way out here. It's pretty shallow all the way through, but it's a cool area. Nice and quiet back here. Here she is. 280. Gotta get it down on the lift so we can take a look at her, but she's brand new. Nice color too. All right, we made it on here, and we're all the way down on the lift. Got the batteries on here, but first, he's got a steering problem. I guess the joystick's not working, throwing codes. I don't see any fluid here. We have two lines on each ram. Make sure we didn't lose any fluid anywhere. I don't see any gold fluid or anything leaking. Everything looks good back here. So let's look under our hatch at our pumps too. All right, it looks good here too. I don't see any leaks anywhere. I don't see any fluid. There's our two pumps right there. There's our two lines, the return line on the other side there. And we got a GPS alarm here. Yes, I know, because our key's not on. It's a Mercury system. It's a new style Simrad too. All right, let me plug in my computer here so we can see what codes we got before we fire these things up. We also want to check his active exhaust or his sport exhaust. He says it might not be turning off. We're plugged in and we got 5.9 hours. Ooh, breaking them in. Let's scan it, find all of our modules. Well, it's finding all of its modules, we got an alarm here. Not sure what that means. 4703-6 joystick starboard engine code. Still loading because it's got 1,000 computers now for two engines. All right, now we're in here. We want to check and make sure that everything's configured, because if you don't configure your steering wheel and everything else, it can also do this problem. So we also want to make sure it has a personality that's matching the boat. So yeah, 28 Boston Whaler, JPO, that's it. All right, well, I'm going to configure this because it's basically just pushing buttons and it tells you what to do. You just push the lever forward, turn the wheel. Real simple. Plus, nobody can do this anyways. Unless you're a dealer watching this, you can't do this without a computer and a laptop and your codes and all that, dealer number and all that fun stuff. So let me get that done and we'll just cut to us firing them up and see if it works, because hopefully after I do this, we're good to go. All right, now we are up to date and we have three active faults. That should tell us something here. Either we got some wiring problems or I got a bad joystick right out of the gate. So if you look here, we got codes, master fault, axis. That's all internal stuff on the joystick. So I'm gonna make a phone call to Mercury real quick. We'll figure out what's going on here. Well, my guess was right here. The joystick itself needs to be replaced. So we went over with Merc. They're gonna send us one, so we replace that. Not a big deal, but let me show you something real quick. I'll show you why we figured this out without having to take anything apart. So here's our codes for the joystick itself here. If we look back, these are all of our modules right here, basically, that are talking to each other. See the CAN right here? So you got H, P, so there's two different CAN lines, the bus networks, basically. So you got P and H. It's seeing it, so it sees the module. And then because it's seeing it, our CCM is reading it, which is what controls our joystick. That's where all the faults are. So if it wasn't plugged in or there's some wiring problems, it wouldn't see this CAN network. So we know that the wiring is good. And if we go to this, and our freeze frame here, we can actually go to info. And if we go to the last one where it says sensors disagree, it's showing faulty joystick or bad wiring. So we've eliminated the wiring because we're seeing the network. So we know the joystick right out of the gate is bad. So we're definitely gonna get another one ordered so we can swap it out. Make sure everything is good after that. But these all should run. And like I said in the beginning of the video, we want to see if our active exhaust or sport exhaust, whatever you want to call it, is stuck on. So we're gonna start these and turn that on and off and listen to it. So our sport exhaust is off right now. Let's fire them up. All right, so the sport exhaust is off right now. see the water just a little bit pushing out here. Plus, the sport exhaust is up underneath there anyways. It would be a lot louder right now. You wouldn't be able to hear me talk. But looking over at this one, it looks a little different. Look at it spitting out the side real hard. There's something missing here. Let's turn the sport exhaust on. A noticeable difference. Yeah, they're both much louder now. Sound a little better actually. This one sounds different too, but I can still see that shouldn't be spitting exhaust out like that. Let's turn these off, trim them up, see what we got. Turn the sport exhaust off first. See, they both quieted it down, so that's not a problem. The sport exhaust is working. All right, we're trimmed up. And let's see. Well, I can see the problem already. So look, right here, that black piece right there is our exhaust. Look on that side. There's not a black piece there. Let's go look and see if there's one on the port side. No, we're completely missing here. Look at that. It's supposed to have that piece on it right there. That's what quiets it down. So she's probably screaming out of these holes when she's running. I don't think I've ever seen that missing before. Well, I guess we're gonna have to figure out how to get this back to the shop, because I'm gonna guess that you got to pull the gear case to reinstall that piece that's missing. All right, before we go here, because that's all I can do with this boat, there's only two problems we got, which our sport exhaust is fine. We just need those pieces, and our joystick is faulty. So let's fire it up one more time and have a listen to the sport exhaust. Definitely throatier sounding for sure. All right, off. Off. Well, that's it for this one. Let me know what you think in the comments if you agree or disagree with what's happening with everything. If you see, there is 15 modules or 15 different computer boards basically talking to each other that I have to look at to figure out what's wrong with the joystick or what's happening, and basically something you can't do by yourself anymore. And a lot of people are getting annoyed with that, because you have to have specialty stuff in order to fix something that's brand new or even a couple years old now. You got to plug into it, which I use my laptop more than anything nowadays. So let me know what you think of that, and if you like it or dislike it. Definitely makes things nice with automation and being able to use a joystick on these littler boats, and just piloting the boat makes it a lot easier, especially with the new style autopilot, all that stuff. So anyway, as always, I appreciate everybody watching, and I will see you next time. Later. There's our coal burning power plant. Chugging away.